Babe, I'm Gonna Leave You Here by Zeppelin. Now, all it amounts to is several chords, and you're just gonna hold those chords while you pretty much just play the piano on the guitar, one string at a time. Let me go through it slowly for you. Here's the first chord, the second one, and we're gonna change here. Change. And this one's a little tough to do. Next one. And then we're gonna have a tough reach here. And then the last one. Okay, so I'm just going to break it down for you like I always do. I'm not going to concentrate on the performance of it. If you want to hear the performance, just listen to the recording. That's the best way you can develop your ear. So, anyway, let's get to the first chord. And you can finger pick it with, you know, one finger at a time if you'd like, or you can use the pick. But the thing you want to do when you use the pick, because there's four strokes per chord, is you want to pick down on the first three. But on the fourth one, when you're down here on these high strings here, you want to pick up, do an upstroke, so that sends your momentum back to the low string, okay? Every time, it's one, two, three, four, this way. If you do four downstrokes, one, two, three, four, then you're way out here, and it's even harder to get back. So make sure you do an upstroke on that last one. And with your pick, on this kind of thing where it's separate strings, it's not strumming, you want to hold it like this with just two fingers. Don't do this. Some of my beginner guitar students do that, and that's a no-no. Don't do that. Hold it on the fingertip of your pointer finger and then your thumb against that, and that gives you a lot more detail, a lot of more intricate work you can do there that way. And just use the tip of your pick, okay? Don't dig it all the way in, you know, getting half the pick on the string like that. Just the very tip is enough, and you want to angle the pick a little bit, the tip of it towards the ceiling a little bit when you're going down, and then turn it that way, angle it a little bit the other way when you're coming up, okay? That'll help your picking a lot, I think. So, here's the first position, A minor. What we want to do, middle finger on the D string. The D string is the third string down from the ceiling, one, two, three. And we want to put our middle finger on the second fret, right there. Then I want to take my ring finger, put it on the second fret as well, on the G string. The G string is the very next string towards the floor, okay? Then I'm gonna take my first finger, my pointer, put it on the first string on the B string. And the B string is the second string up from the floor. So not this one, but this one, first fret. Now, got my fingers there, now use your fingertips. Girls, you need to trim your nails if your nails are too long. You cannot play guitar if you have long nails. Impossible on your left hand. You can have them long on your right hand for picking, of course, but there's our A minor chord. Curve your fingers, test it out. If you get this, then you know you're not pressing a string down hard enough, or you're muting strings by being down, by pulling back too far this way. Okay, so up on your fingertips there, low wrist, get the wrist away from the neck. Now, on the picking, we're going to do A string, then the D string, then the G string. And we're going to skip the B string and go to the high E. You may say, well, why do we have this finger down if we're going to skip it? Well, the next time we go through, we're not going to skip it. So just go ahead and put it down for now. So A, D, G, and then the high E, up pick. And give it a little accent to that high E, because that's kind of a little melody note there. So we want, I did it too much, I exaggerated, but. Now, here's the next thing we want to do. Keep your left hand the same. Pick the A, pick the D, pick the G string. Now we do want to pick the B string, and we'll leave out the high E, so the B string this time. So here are the first two sets of four. Okay, here's the first set of four. One, two, three, four. Second set of four. One, two, three, four. All right? And I'm accenting a little too much there on that last one. But anyway, now, next position. Lift your ring finger. Keep these two down, but you want to slide them to the right. Your right, just a little bit, stay in the same fret. But just slide over a little bit. Now take your ring finger, put it on the low E on the third fret, okay? And then take your pinky, put it on the B string right here, as in boy, on the third fret. And you got all four fingers down there. Now again, you're thinking maybe, why do I have two fingers on the B string? Why do I? Because you're gonna need this finger later, so we're just gonna keep it down. Now here's what you pick. Let me make sure I have it right. Yeah, all right. Low E, Then we're going to skip the A string and go to the D string. Then we're going to do the G string open. And then we're going to pick the B string. So 1, 2, 3, 4. All right? Now here's what you do for the next chord. All you do is lift up your pinky. Okay? This pinky was just doing a suspension. It was just suspending the C note in this C chord. So we're going to lift up the pinky now. And then we're going to pick the low E, the D, then the G, and then the B string. All right, so we've done four things. Here's the first one. Here's the second one. Third one. Fourth one. Lift the pinky up. Accenting the fourth group of each, or the fourth note of each group. Now, here's the next one. This is the tough one. Is it the thumb chord, okay? Wrap your thumb around. If you can't get it at first, don't worry. I couldn't get it at first either when I learned it a few years back. But you have to get that thumb around there and get that low E. If the neck's too thick, it may not be your fault. You may need to get a better guitar. If you've got one of those acoustic guitars that have just a big, thick block of wood for the neck, good luck on that. So we want to wrap our thumb around second fret. We're not muting. We want a note out of it. So, okay? Now, what I have now is my middle finger here on the G string, third string from the floor, on second fret. And then I have my first finger still on the first fret on the B. And then I put this ring finger back down on the third fret on the B string. I got to hurry. I don't want to run out of time here. So I've got that chord here, and I'm going to do low E, then open D string. Open. Nothing's touching it. Then G string, and then the B string. What I'm going to do, lift this finger up. Lift it up, and now I'm ready for the next one. Low E, then D string, G string, B string. Okay? I'm going to go ahead and finish the chord so I don't run out of time. Now, you can borrow this chord, but I think it's easier to do this. Leave this finger there, leave this finger where it is, take this ring finger and put it on the third fret on the D string, D as in dog here, and then let's take the thumb, let's move it to the first fret of the low E and do that. And we're going to pick the low E, then the D, and then the G, and then the B string. All right, got to hurry. Watch what I'm going to do. I'm going to lift my thumb. I'm going to lift my pointer finger. And I'm going to take these two fingers, and I'm going to go to the left, one fret. Now I'm ready to do this part. Low E. And then the D string. And then the G. And then the B. All right, I got 1 minute left. And for those frets, I have second fret D, first fret G. All right, all the way through. First chord. Second. Third. Fourth. Fifth. Sixth.